Should be done.
Ah, ok. Now
Okay.
it's working. Perfect.
Okay, great.
Perfect. So, first of all, it was fascinating to discover that in your life you've been also involved in cars.
Yes.
Hey, what
My
happened? How you switched from cars to watches?
it was my first love. I start to design cars when I was during my childhood, so I don't remember, 4 or 5 years. And when I was after the university for the thesis for the degree, I was invited by Fiat to have an experience in their design team. And after this experience and after my degree thesis, I become a car designer of the Fiat Centro Stile in Turin. So great experience. We are talking about the last century, so 1997, 1996, I don't remember well. Until 2001 when I joined Bulgari. But for me, cars and watches are exactly the same. More or less, we talk about engine, we talk about aesthetics. Often we talk about the same client. So for me, it's interesting to design products. If we are talking about cars, watches, or jewelry, or furniture, sunglasses, for me is almost the same. My biggest passion is to make sketches.
By the way, how do you see the cooperation with Maserati? As you know, there are several cooperations between cars and watch maison, watch companies. How you
Yeah.
position your Bulgari watches for Maserati?
Two Italian brands, very old, with the same attention to beauty and details. Maserati was very well known after the Second World War to become the GT car. The Ferrari was more involved in racing competition, and the Maserati was more the luxury sport car. Bulgari is a bit the same. We are not obsessed by performance, even if we put records year after year. But in terms of design, in terms of way of thinking behind the products, we are not obsessed by truly performance. So as you can see in our Octofinissimo chronograph tourbillon, for example, we put attention on the movement. We put the attention on the technical feature. This is the watch that we presented in our last event in Geneva. But you see, it's a watch that if you want, you can wear every day because it's very elegant in terms of design. This is my taste for sure. It's absolutely unique in terms of technical features. Our attention on the movement is exactly the same attention that you find in exotic cars in terms of engine. But on the other hand, it's a sport chic watch. So Maserati and Bulgari has many elements in common, are not driven just by performance, but even for the aesthetic of the performance and by the comfort and the place and the pleasure. You have to have fun, absolutely, when you drive a Maserati, and you have to stay in a very elegant car. And the same concept is for the Bulgari watch. So performance and elegance. Italian design, a Swiss watchmaking know-how.
Please continue to present the novelties because unfortunately we've been unable to join because of pandemic
Yeah,
regulations.
sure. So this watch, the Tourbillon, is absolutely a piece of art. We spent 3 years almost to develop the movement, and unfortunately, no elements in common with the chronograph GMT that we presented last year. The watch is 3.5 millimeter the movement and 7.4 millimeter the thickness of the case. We decided to use a see-through dial to admire this amazing piece of technology that we are able to produce in our facilities. We have more or less 55 hours in terms of power reserve, and we use the push button at 2 to start, stop, and reset the chronograph function. So it's an integrated movement with the peripheric rotor. I'll show you all the period, the rotor, the turns around the movement, mm-hmm. and these fantastic levers to activate the chronograph function. It's absolutely amazing, as you can see.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. 3 years of an amazing job. Thanks to our manufacturing side, thanks to our watchmasters, thanks to our product development process, even our design team. So the idea is to wear in a different way a Grand Complication watch. Absolutely in a more Italian way, very casual, let me say. But if you want, you can hide this piece of art under your shirt. Otherwise, you know that you are wearing one of the most complicated movement today on the market. This is the thinnest tourbillon, automatic tourbillon today on the market. Titanium case, titanium bracelet, titanium buckle, and great success during the Geneva watch days. Almost sold out the entire production for the first year, 50 pieces, and it was a great, great achievement. Another important novelty is that we already presented in Dubai and again we presented in Geneva. It was the Octo S. The Octo S, it means steel, it means sport. It's the latest execution on the Octo world. Mm-hmm. And we introduced two dial, the black matte finishing and the blue one that I have on my wrist. So we change the water resistant rates. Today we have 100 meters and you see the two watches, more or less you have the same dial, but the blue one is a sun blasted finishing, sun ray, and it's a more sporty 100 meters water resistant. We increase the thickness of the glass, we change the gasket. So it's the latest execution on the Octo Finissimo range for this kind of segment. We are talking about 12,000 euros for this watch. So it's less expensive than the titanium one. The titanium one, it was an amazing success. Still today, it was very important for the brand to set a statement in terms of design. The movement is the same, but after 4 years of gray titanium, the idea was to change a bit and to enlarge the clients of the Octo Finissimo. So for many clients, it was a bit a niche, the titanium one. For the market, the biggest part of the male watches is the steel sport watches. So today we are absolutely in this segment.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Allow me to ask you some questions. It's of course Octo is your opera, and it's step by step going to an icon status. What was your philosophy behind the whole design? Because obviously it's not by coincidence. That to me it's obvious. You didn't simply went to this solution by coincidence. It was well conceived. So please describe the DNA of the Octo collection.
The DNA of the Octo collection is very close to the DNA of the brand. Bulgar is not a common brand. Starting from the origins, so we are the unique brand in the art luxury that comes from Rome. And our idea was from the beginning to change the rules in different segments. We were the first to use cabochon cut and semi-precious stones. In jewelry world, we were the first to use porcelain, aluminum, and caoutchouc in fine watches. So we love to play with common material in unconventional way. That's why the first minute repeater, the thinnest minute repeater that we produced in titanium, wasn't a great success, because for the first time, the most impressive and the most noble complication movement that you can find in the Swiss watchmaking heritage was made with this kind of material. So, sorry, Dan.
Bless you.
So the idea was to change completely the rules in the ultra thin segment. That's why we decided to have the titanium. That's why we decided to have just one material and one finishing for this kind of pieces. So great success. You have to imagine that for the first time in the ultra thin execution, you have not just a round shaped watch with a thin bezel and white face. The Octo Finissimo is absolutely unique in terms of design, but unique, it means that you love it or you don't love it, but for sure it's absolutely contemporary. So for the first time, an ultra thin execution with a contemporary and daring design. The idea behind was very simple, to wear a grand complication in an Italian way, in a absolutely more discreet, in absolutely more Italian. So if you want, you can hide, or otherwise you can show your amazing piece of mechanical art. This was the idea at the beginning, to play with this kind of design, the octagonal shape and the round bezel. It's something that you find in our assortment since from the late 70s. It was Gianni Bulgari, the first one to introduce this kind of design thanks to a coin collection. So as you can see in our history, we love to play with geometrical shape and pure forms. And when you combine together, you generate a new aesthetics. This is the, this is our approach in terms of shapes. Behind the Octo, we have this kind of attitude. We have the Octo Roma, we have the Octo Finissimo, we have six world record. So for us is the main pillar. And we keep working on this watch for the future with different execution, with different materials and different, different movements. So we will see in the next future. You have to imagine, Dan, that we start today to talk about products for the next 4 or 5 years. So the tourbillon, the chronograph tourbillon, now you see on the tray after 3 years, 3 years and a half of development just for the movement. Because sometimes, you know, the limit is the thickness of some components, and we don't have the tools sometimes to develop some things, so some components. That's why you have to imagine that now we are talking about 3-4 years development for a watch like this.
Understood. In terms of materials, what is new for the watchmaking industry in the Octo Finissimo collection, beyond the record being the finest watches, the finest tourbillon and so on?
But, you know, it's not so difficult to have your own material. You could ask to the Lausanne University, and they combine together a different mix of alloy that everybody knows. A bit of titanium, a bit of aluminum, a bit of iron, and you have your alloy, each time with the same color, more or less with different performance. But our idea is not to use exotic material just to have a press kit. Our idea is to play with a common material in an unconventional way. So in our story, in our history, you find aluminum and caoutchouc for the first time, for example, combined together to generate a new color scheme. For the first time, you have titanium with this kind of finishing. For the first time, you have in a jewelry world, in a jewelry company, able to produce a gold watch without any shiny surfaces. So, and when you see the watch, you see that it's a completely different color thanks to a different finishing. So sometimes you have a several way to use titanium grade 5. You have to find your way to use maybe the common material in your way, in an unconventional way. It depends on your DNA, it depends on your roots. So again, when you see on our tray today, now we have the aluminum, for example. It's a watch that everybody all our clients knows very well.
Correct.
It's an iconic product. We start to introduce the aluminum in 1988, if I remember well, because during those time, the space frame from the automotive industry was the biggest technological advance after many, many years. Today, the aluminum is still more contemporary, if it's possible, because all our electronic devices, all our iPads, all our laptops are made with the aluminum, and they have a black push button, they have black screen. So this kind of materials and this kind of color scheme, it's more actual today than 30 years ago. That's why the watch, when you see the watch on the wrist, is still contemporary. First of all, we don't use applied decorative elements. And after, we use just geometrical shape and then just one clever idea. When you have to introduce and make a new icon, you have to imagine that you need just one idea. You are not obliged to introduce many, many technological elements, because otherwise the clients, it's a bit confusing. So just one idea, a design able to talk about your brand, and maybe you have the right ingredients for the iconic receipt. But just the market can tell you after 20, 30 years if you are talking about an iconic product. Today, I'll tell you, I'm honest with you, all the most important watch collectors around the world are saying that the Octo Finissimo is the most iconic watch of the last 30 years. So for the aluminum, for example, you see many loyal clients that ask to wear again the aluminum, but you have even our younger client that needs a new watch, very affordable in terms of price, with an incredible know-how and with an amazing brand behind. So after 30 years, we decided to reintroduce the aluminum, and we start from scratch, absolutely from scratch, because at those time, we don't have any advance in terms of technology. Today, we don't use the same machine, the same tools. And at those time, they used to make drawings, technical drawings by hand. Today, we use the computer, 2D computer and 3D computer. So we decided to have exactly the same watch, but we started from scratch. So as you can see, through the Octo Finissimo Tourbillon, and the aluminum, we have exactly the same approach. A different way to wear a complicated watch and a different way to use common materials. This is the heritage of the brand. As I said before, we were the first to use cabochon cut in the jewelry world. We were the first to use colored gemstones in fine jewelry. And today we are the first to use titanium in minute repeater. Today we are the first again to use aluminum and caoutchouc. So as you can see, through different products in terms of aesthetic, you find exactly the same approach and exactly the same DNA.
Fabrizio, allow me to ask you 2-3 short questions, and yeah, I will appreciate very short answers. First, do you imagine in the Bulgari range any kind of new, let's say, trend of connected kind of Bulgari watch?
In terms of brand, I would say, why not? In terms of lineup and assortment, I say maybe now is not the right time. We are, our focus on the Octo Finissimo is very important. Today we have a new watch in our assortment, is the aluminum. We introduce even the new Gerald Genta Arena Biretro Sport. Our assortment is very clear and very clean in this moment. So the smartwatches and the connected watches, you have to imagine that behind there is an amazing job in terms of ecosystem. It's not just a product that you can put on the wrist of your client. You have to keep working every day to develop apps and to develop the operative system. So it's a different job. You need a very important partner to develop this technology in the best ways possible.
One other question is regarding the trends in Otto Rogerie, where of course your work is a part of. What do you think in the next years, let's say after pandemic years, will be in trend? What kind of watches with a lot of complications, less complications? How this pandemic affected your work?
You know, the market is very big in terms of niche, in terms of product categories, in terms of geographic taste, let me say. After this moment, maybe we don't have just one watch. The biggest trend is not maybe the product. The biggest trend is able to be reactive, able to be very fast in terms of reaction when you have this kind of event. I'll tell you, we start to develop, we talk about aluminum at the beginning of this year during the lockdown. And today we have the watch on our tray. We have an amazing product development office. We have amazing watch masters and manufacturing side able to produce from scratch a watch that for sure we already know in terms of technology in 6 months. I think this is the biggest achievement that you could have during a period like that. Able to produce a watch that have to answer to a specific question from the market. For sure, we're going to have an amazing request in terms of high-end watches, high jewelry pieces, because you know, the rich people are always richer and richer. But the biggest problem is the entry price point. That's why we have a very iconic and affordable watch today in terms of price. We talk about less than 3,000 euros for the hour, minute, and second, and a bit more than 4,000 euros for the chronograph in the aluminum lineup. Mm-hmm. So reactive with the right product, and the right price point at the right moment. I think this is the answer.
The last question, and it's a personal question for you personally, which is the complication you love most?
Hour, minute, and second is the most complicated watch that you can imagine to design. When you have a Quantième Perpétuel, Tourbillon, chronograph, alarm, minute repeater, grand sonnerie, you have just to design a dial full of different functions. When you have just hour, minute, and second, you have just the DNA of the brand in a very wide space that you have to fill with all the elements of the brand. And honestly, it's not so easy at all. Well, but for sure, I love chronograph. I love because it's the most useful complication. And even the GMT, because we travel a lot. And the GMT, I think GMT and chronograph are the most useful. But if I have to tell you, in terms of creative process, the most difficult one is the hour, minute, and second. Sometimes you don't have, you have just hour and minutes, so it's even worse.
Thank you very much, Fabrizio. It was a real pleasure talking to you, and thank you for your time. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It was a great pleasure. Take care. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.